We really enjoyed our last mindfulness and art video, so we wanted to make another one today. We'll do a quick mindfulness activity and then some art that you can join in with at home.
Okay, so today's mindfulness activity is a really simple one. What we're going to do today is you're just going to give yourself a great big hug. It is a really stressful time at the moment, and it's really important that we recognise all of the work that our mind is doing and our body is doing to get us through this time. And you're going to congratulate yourself, and we're going to think about and reflect on what you're feeling proud of today. Are you ready to have a go? Okay. Okay, so you should be sat somewhere that is calm and quiet, somewhere where you can really focus. We're going to start our activity. I just want you to give yourself a great big squeeze. So wrap your arms around your body, and I want you to really squeeze to give yourself a great big hug. Whilst you're doing that, can you close your eyes? And I want you to think about one thing from today that makes you feel proud. It might be something you did. It might be something in your learning you achieved. Something to do with your gem powers. One thing from today that you feel really proud of.
Okay.
Well, start to concentrate on your breathing. I want you to take a big deep breath in. So inhale. And release. Exhale. Okay. We're going to do that a few more times. Ready to go together? Inhale. And exhale. I want you to continue to do that until you are feeling calm and present. When you're feeling relaxed and calm and ready, then you're ready to start.
So, for today's art activity, you don't need very much. You need a piece of paper again, and you need anything with colour that you can mark make with. Today I'm going to use some watercolours
and I've got felt tips.
You also need anything you have that can play music. You might be able to play that through your television, you might have some sort of radio or some sort of CD player. I've got some speakers here that I'm going to use, so anything that plays music that you have at home. So today's activity is mark making to music. I'm sure you're aware and that you'd agree that music is another thing that can really, really help us tune into our feelings. So a combination of the two is something that I find really, really useful. The first thing you need to do is you need to take your piece of paper, you need to fold it into four equal sections. I would do this by folding it in half, and then folding your half in half.
Ah, so you've put your paper into quarters.
Four equal parts, that's right. And if you open up, you should see one, two, three, four equal parts. Each of these sections is going to be a different piece of music. So if we listen to the first piece of music.
Makes me want to smile, this one.
It's definitely a happy piece of music, isn't it? So if, like Marcel and I, you are feeling happy listening to this music, you could think about the colours from yesterday that might have been associated with a happy feeling for you. I'm going to start with something quite bright. What about you, Marcel?
I've gone straight for a yellow.
So, Marcel, I'd be really interested in seeing what you created on your page based on that piece of music.
So for me, that was a really happy, positive piece of music, and it made me think of going on a journey on quite a hot, sunny day. So I've reflected that in my drawing. I've drawn a road here, which is where I'm going on my journey. Beautiful blue sky, big sun, and there's some flowers by the roadside as well. What have you done?
I went more for colours and for patterns. I've gone for a super bright yellow. That's a really happy song for me. And then I did some dots that look like confetti, because that's a song that for me is quite associated with different parties that I've been at where that song's been playing. So I wanted to show that in the painting that I did.
Both so different, that's interesting.
Shall we listen to another piece of music?
Yes, let's.
Piece of music number two, I think you're going to find quite different to number one.
Sometimes I feel so happy. Sometimes I feel so sad.
I'm already not getting the same pictures and colours in my head as I was for the first piece of music. I'm not thinking of the colour yellow and of parties anymore.
But mostly you just make me mad.
Should we have a go at getting that out onto paper?
I think these ones are going to be quite different.
looking at your piece of paper and I think we've gone for quite a similar vibe. I've done lots of different shades of blue in quite kind of wavy, gentle patterns. Do you want to know something, Michelle?
What?
That song is actually called Pale Blue Eyes. It's by...
Oh, I didn't know that.
It's by a band called The Velvet Underground. We will put all of the names of the songs in this video once we've recorded it. But look how similar, even though we've used a different media, we've actually had a fairly similar image conjured in our heads by that piece of music.
I was using lots of cold colours because it didn't give me the same positive feeling. What's up next?
Let's see.
Good choice. No, I'm not thinking cold colours anymore. What are you thinking?
I'm thinking parties and brights and lots of different shades of lots and lots of different colours.
Oh, let's get started.
So, are you ready to reveal?
Yes.
Ta-da! Oh.
I went for lots of bright, vibrant colours because it just made me think party, party, and I've actually chose to represent those as fireworks.
I love that. I went for kind of something similar. I was thinking of how at a disco you'd have some strobe lights.
Oh, yeah.
So I've gone for these big circles of bright colour to show that kind of lighting effect with some party, streamery type things. Ready for number four?
Yes.
Track number four is completely different again. I... wonder what colours it will conjure in your head.
I'm excited.
I feel much calmer this time round.
It is calming, actually.
I quite like the drum beat in the background, though.
I feel like I could replicate some sort of music like this at home.
Don't have as clear a picture in my head of what I'm going to paint this time, but that's really interesting because I might just see what comes out when I start painting and playing the music.
Let's have a go. Okay, what have you gone for?
I went for a sunrise. If you can see, I've got kind of a night sky fading out into brightness where the sun is starting to rise. I just had a really clear picture of that time of the day in my head.
That's so interesting because actually I drew a moonlit night.
No way.
Kind of the opposite.
Complete opposite.
I've chosen a few different greys to represent my moon. I can try to do some moonlight coming off it that was a bit tricky. And I actually represented my stars in different shades of purple.
How interesting. Mm. So what we've got today is four completely different artworks based on four completely different songs. Now, we will put these songs into the video we make, but you could do this with any songs at all.
Choose your own songs.
You could choose your own songs for someone at home and compare your artwork with theirs, like Michelle and I have done today. So hopefully this is a really open-ended activity that you can do in lots of different ways anytime you want. I really hope you enjoyed it. And tune in next time. Ooh, who knows what will happen next time, Michelle. What a thrill. Bye, Big Brit.
Bye.